The views and opinions expressed on the following program are not necessarily those of the staff and management of KLAY or those who advertise their products or services on this station.
Viva Entertainment Talk Radio on Play 1180 AM. I am Shell Culp with Essence of Events. Thank you for joining us. I am filling in today for Johnny the Capo at Viva Entertainment Talk Radio. You can see any of his information on viva-entertainment.com. That's viva-productions.com. And you can find me at www.essenceofevents.com. That's wedding and event planning here in the Tacoma area. We have a great show planned for you today. We're looking at having one of the Major League Baseball players, Mariners game. They have the photographer there, Trong Nguyen, joining us today on the show. Him and I have been friends for quite some time now. He's shot quite a few weddings as well here in the Tacoma area, as well as up in Seattle. And we're looking forward to learning a little bit more about what he does, what got him into the business. And then we're going to follow up with Lisa Santa Cruz. And she is joining us as a former client and bride. So we'll get a little bit of information from her firsthand of her wedding planning experience and about the Brides Club shows, how she met us at Essence of Events, and get a little bit more information on some tips as well for you wedding and event planners as well as brides. I get a lot of questions when it comes to budgets, and when we have events that come up, a lot of people want to know certain etiquette and have questions all the time. A while back, I did an article in the Consumer Reports magazine. I had Toby Stranger contact me and just wanting some recommendations of how people could save some money. We know here up in the Seattle area, there's recent information that the weddings are costing about $25,000 to $30,000. So we have a lot of people that want to know any ways that they could save money within their budget. So one of the ways that I had recommended was when you go into your catering company or your venue, a lot of times they will ask for a guest count. Now, you may not already have your list in place of your guests and who you want there. You may have an idea. I recommend that you put a list together before. I recommend that you do it in what I call an ABC list. A being the guests where it's your immediate family, the must-haves, let's say, in your family and friends. And then your B list is going to be those who are on a broader scope. So maybe relatives are out of state. And then you're going to also have those friends that are your outer circle. And then your C list is going to include those like from your office associates, or from acquaintances, or people that maybe you haven't seen for quite a few years. So my recommendation would be put that together, start pulling from your A list, and as you put it together, then move into your B list and try and keep it within a certain amount of a guest count that goes along with your budget plan. So how you're going to do that is you're going to figure out about how much you want to spend, and then you're going to divide that by, let's say, 100. And so you're going to come up with a number, and then that is going to give you the exact count and cost per person. And so when you factor that in, you can then go back and say, okay, is this a reasonable amount that is going to allow me to pay for my venue, my catering, my photographer? And, you know, if you do have some people who maybe our family friends that are photographers, professional photographers, or you're bringing in your own food to, let's say, a community center, then of course you're going to want to factor those costs in differently. So you can almost go and categorize them and then take out the ones that you don't need, because some people don't do transportation. So you can take those ones out. So you're going to come up with your list, your final number, and then you're going to go to the venue and you're going to talk to them and give them an estimate. Now, if your count's at 100, don't be afraid to give them an 80 or 85 count. What this does is it essentially locks you in at that number without making you have the commitment of 100 guests and then having to pay for 100 when only 85 show up. So if you lock that in, then you can get an estimate based off of that 85. And make sure that any estimate, especially with catering or any service based, includes the percentages of tax and gratuity. And then you're gonna factor in negotiating. So don't be afraid to negotiate your contracts. Anything is negotiable. I always say the worst outcome is that you're just in the same situation as you began. So, you know, you're hoping for that yes. You're hoping that they're willing to give you what you're looking for. But, you know, be willing to kind of have a balance as well and be open to hearing their ideas. And then we have coming up here pretty soon, we have Trong coming. I'm really excited to talk to him more about the photography and get his ideas on how he got into the industry and kind of what questions are commonly asked by couples. And we're going to have a lot of information on that. And then another idea too is when you have your alcohol. Some venues allow you to bring that in, but often you have to have a banquet permit. And here in Pierce County, it's usually only about $10 to $15. So what a lot of couples try to do is see if their venues are willing to allow them to bring in outside alcohol and beverages, and that's going to save you a ton of money. Some charge a bottle corkage fee, so you want to double check on that with the venues as well. But if you can bring in your own alcohol, you're essentially going to save hundreds of dollars. And then you can also find your own bartenders if a lot of these venues will allow you to. Venues like community centers, they're more popular of the choices for ones with alcohol. Now, if you're looking for full service, which is a lot easier than having to go out and figure how many, you know, cases of beer do I need a keg, or how many cases of wine am I going to need, and you just want a professional to handle it, it's a great idea to just get a place that does an all-in-one. And a really great venue around here is actually the Landmark. That is the convention center here in Tacoma. And Johnny actually works with them as well. And there's a great, great package deal that they have there. So, you know, they've got catering in-house. They've got a DJ in-house if you need it. They've got bartending. So it's a great place to go to have your wedding and have it all-inclusive, which you're dealing with less vendors that way. It's a lot better communication as well. And they also offer a little bit of planning too, or recommendations for planners. And Lisa, who's coming up here pretty soon as well, she's our second guest on the show. She actually got married there. And we're going to talk more later about her fairy tale wedding. It's an unbelievable story and an incredible happy ending. And it's a very inspiring story for me as well, because we actually met at the Brides Club Wedding Expo. And so she had come in there before, and we'll talk a little bit about this later, but we had ran into each other, kind of struck up a little bit of a conversation, and then she ended up coming back. And so the shows are actually coming up here pretty soon. So we have a Brides Club show here in Tacoma at the Tacoma Dome, and that will be on September 8th through the 9th. And so I encourage you guys to get on bridesclub.com and to take a look around and see what kind of vendors are going to be there. And just, I'm really amped up about this year's show. I think it's going to be a really successful show. Things are kind of picking up quite a bit in the wedding industry. We know a few years back, it was kind of, there's a little bit of a lull. But here in Tacoma, we've got quite a few wonderful vendors who are going to be among the vendors at that show, and I encourage you to kind of sign up for that and attend if you can. That's on Saturday and Sunday, September 8th and 9th. And we have coming up here Trong Nguyen with TMP Photography, and he will be talking more about photographing for the Mariners. And I know he was at last night's show with the fireworks, so that was really exciting. So we'll talk to him a little bit more about that when we come up here. And please join me back in just a few minutes.
Play Radio, Tacoma's radio station. Play keeps you informed. 1180 AM.
Tacoma's radio station.
Attention business owners. Experience a new world of business with barter. The Saturn Barter Company, located in Tacoma, is one of the most beneficial business decisions you can make. Using Saturn Barter, you are able to sell your products or services to other members of the exchange. You can then use that credit you've built up from your sales to purchase the products or services you or your company needs from other companies within Saturn Barter, all without the use of cash. Contact and join Saturn Barter Club today, 253-212-9930, or online at SaturnBarter.com.
This is Johnny the Gangster with Viva Productions, King of Entertainment, one-stop shop for all your entertainment needs. We have DJ service for weddings, corporate, and private events. Thrill your guests with Vegas Nights Casino Party, Blackjack, Craps, Roulette, Poker, and more. We also have event photography and limousine service. Call Viva Productions, 206-542-5733, or find us at Viva-Productions.com. A little less conversation, a little more action, you got it. Call Johnny the Gangster, I'll make you a deal you can't refuse.
Brides, do you want your big day to be stress-free, perfect, and stay within your budget? Well, Brides Club has all the inside information to make your dream a reality. Go to BridesClub.com, that's BridesClub.com. See upcoming bridal shows and events, view wedding vendors and special offers. And don't miss The Spotlight, the premier online wedding magazine with valuable articles you can't afford to miss. Brides Club helps make your wedding stress-free and perfect. Go to BridesClub.com. Check out BridesClub.com.
Life's a celebration. Grand Event Rentals makes your event their top priority. They are your full-service, special event, and party rental provider, supplying everything you need from start to finish. Their professional sales team and event staff work with you to create your dream event. With every event, Grand Event Rentals' customers' needs are the most important. Whether you're planning an intimate outdoor wedding or an elaborate black tie gala, the Grand Event Rental specialists make great pride in providing our event planning experience to help create an unforgettable event. Please go and visit the Bellevue Showroom, Grand Event Rentals, or make a one-on-one appointment. Talk to them. They're trained, they're knowledgeable, they're event specialists, and they are going to take you through step-by-step everything that you need to make your day a success. Call Grand Event Rentals. Their number is 425-462-7368, or go to grandeventrentalswa.com.
Is your vehicle needing some attention? Take it over to Maddie's Tuning and Shoreline for fast, affordable car care. Trusted, professional, Maddie's services all makes and models and has been trusted in the Puget Sound for almost 60 years. Call Brian Maddie at 206-364-3347 or stop by his convenient location in Shoreline right on Aurora at 152nd. Maddie's Tuning. Call 206-364-3347. Trusted for almost 60 years to keep you safe and on the road.
Play Radio, Tacoma's radio station. Play keeps you informed. 1180 AM.
Tacoma's radio station.
Oh, into the chapel and we're gonna get married. Go into the chapel and we're
This is Michelle with Viva Entertainment Talk Radio on KLAY 1180 AM. It looks like Trong is in the middle of an actual photo shoot with the Mariners right now, so we're going to try and catch up with him later. We don't want to interrupt that photo shoot. I'm sure he'll be posting those photos on Facebook, which I look forward to seeing. In the meantime, we're trying to get Lisa on so that we can kind of chat with her for a bit about her wedding and the fairy tale ending that she's had with that, and a little exciting news as well. What we're going to go into now is just talking about local events here in Tacoma. We mentioned the Brides Club Wedding Expo. We also have often at the Harmon Tap Room, Johnny plays on Fridays. Oftentimes they have at 8 o'clock as well. I know last night they had the open mic. That's kind of fun if you're looking for events in the area, something fun to do. I stopped in there last week and Johnny's band was playing, and that was really fun and exciting. A lot of vendors in the area. I encourage you to check that out, as well as the Brides Club Wedding Expo. Looks like we have Lisa on the line. She's going to join us right now. Hello, Lisa. How are you?
Hi, Michelle. I'm doing great.
Oh, my goodness. I'm so excited to talk to you. I've kind of been keeping an eye on you on Facebook.
Yeah.
And your cute little family. Maybe we could just go into a little bit of an introduction on how we met. So if you want to tell a little bit about that, I'd love to let the listeners in on that.
Yeah, absolutely. So we met at the Tacoma Wedding Expo. I think the first time I went, I had a long engagement, so I ended up going twice because it was fun and wedding stuff is fun. So me and my mom went to the wedding expo, and it was a really just great place to kind of get started. There's so many decisions to make and vendors to hire.
Yeah, so this was the Brides Club Wedding Expo, right, here in Tacoma?
Right, yeah. Mm-hmm. Right, the Brides Club.
Yeah.
In the Dome. Yeah, so we went around, and I remember meeting you, and I just remember that you stuck out to me a lot. I felt like you had a great click, a great connection. And then I remember going home, and we would just go through all of, you know, all the business cards we got, trying to remember and going through, oh, I don't even remember who they are, but, you know, oh, I remember them. They were great.
Yeah. Was there like a strategy behind that? I know with some people, they just kind of all dump it out on the floor. Did you like separate them or did you like take little notes? Any tips for those out there who are going to be going to the show would be great.
Yeah. I think for me, when I was there, I just tried to go and talk to as many people as I could just to ask questions. And because one of my most important things was making sure that I was going to hire vendors that I really wanted to work with. Like, these are going to be people you're going to be interacting with on your wedding day. So, you know, there's so many great people out there, but you want someone that you feel comfortable with and that you click with. And so that's the great part about that wedding expo, you know, because if you go and Google, you know, people, you know, you'll get a bunch of stuff, but you don't really know who you're hiring. So at the expo, you can go actually talk to these people, have them make an impression on you, and, you know, take their card, maybe write a note down. But we just went around talking to people and just trying to get a sense of who they were and if they would be a good fit for me to have around on my wedding day. And it was a lot of fun. And so then we went home and just kind of dumped everything out and just kind of went by who we remembered, who really made an impression. And if, you know, we saw a card that we didn't really remember who they were, then obviously, you know, they probably weren't going to be a good choice. So it was definitely obvious the few, you know, that we did end up hiring, like you and I think our photographer we also met there. You guys just stood out and we just made a connection. And so then when we went back the next time, I remember we hunted you down and we're like, okay, you're on. We need you a part of our wedding.
So you went not just once, but you went twice?
Twice, so that's probably a little unusual, but we had plenty of time. So I think we went the first time like pretty right after we got engaged, just to kind of start getting our head in the water of wedding planning. But at that point, you know, we had a 2-year engagement, so at that point my wedding was still 2 years out, so it was kind of still a little early to be hiring people. People were like, you know, that date wasn't even on people's register yet. So then when we went back, it was kind of closer to a little over a year out, so it was kind of at the perfect time to be getting on people's calendars. And so it was fun. And it was fun to go back because our mission for the second trip was, let's go meet these people again, kind of confirm that, yes, we got the click, and then, you know, get on their calendar and snag them up.
So how did you follow up after the show? I don't really remember. Did we set an appointment there? I remember your energy, and I remember your mom, and you guys were super cute together. I was like, I was like, so cute that you guys were coming in there. And, you know, I remember your energy, and you're absolutely beautiful, too. Stunning bride, too. But it was, it was your energy. And, you know, as a vendor, that is always nice to see, too, in brides that are really interested in finding a personal fit, because not everybody goes together, but to have that kind of, you know, energy flow and the communication was there, you know, that was something that as a vendor, I really appreciated, because you guys were very open about what your needs were and what you were looking for. So you had a game plan in place, but you guys were also really flexible too in hearing the advice, you know, from a professional, from somebody, you know, who has experience in the field, which from my perspective, I completely appreciated. So, so did you guys end up booking your venue? First of all, what was your venue?
Our venue, the ceremony venue was the First Lutheran Church, which that I had hunted down through just hunting down all the pretty churches in the area, because I was set on my big church wedding. And, of course, a lot of the bigger churches were Catholic churches, which I'm not Catholic, so kind of finding one that would allow me to get
again,
married.
Personalization.
Exactly. Yeah. But the our reception venue was the Temple Theater, and I think that was also... I don't think we found them at the expo. I think we saw their little booth at the expo.
Yeah,
that
that's a part. Yep. The Temple Theater is actually a big venue, which is a part of the Landmark Catering and Convention Center in Tacoma that I mentioned earlier in the show. I don't know if you were listening in, but I mentioned that was here in Tacoma. So your reception was there.
Yeah, our reception was there, and I had hunted them down because, again, I knew I wanted a big, grand as I could get, and that was definitely the place that popped up that had, you know, a big, beautiful ballroom. So I had gotten in touch with them and went on, you know, toured some of their rooms and just fell in love with that ballroom, and they were really great to work with.
Now, did you run into them at the show at all? Do you remember?
I did. I did remember seeing them at the show.
Yeah, because I'm pretty sure they're there every year, and they're going to be in this year's show as well. Yeah.
I think they had I remember walking by, I was like, oh, they had a pretty big space. So it's fun to be like, hey, like I already hired you, but you guys are awesome. So,
So you mentioned that you had gotten engaged. How long before you ended up going to the show the first time?
I think the first time it might've just been like the next month or something. I can't remember exactly, but I think, you know, I think it was just, you know, after Nathaniel had left on his way to Okinawa. So we were just eager to dive right in and just, you know, fill our time with happy wedding cake. So I think we went pretty soon after.
Yeah. Why don't you tell our listeners about your wonderful fairy tale story of how you guys even met, and your courtship was so adorable and so classic and traditional. And I love that. I love that.
Yeah, we had a pretty sweet story. So we met down at Century Ballroom in Seattle. We met swing dancing. We had kind of had a few mutual friends, but had never met before. So he asked me to dance, and we kind of hit it off. But we met only about 2, maybe 3 weeks before he was going to ship out to boot camp for the Marine Corps. So we only had just this tiny bit of time to get to know each other, but we just fell head over heels so quickly and just kind of dove straight in and just said, we're going to do this. You know, it's going to be hard and long distance for most of it, but we're ready. And so all of that whirlwind, and then he was off to boot camp. And so for 3 months, you know, it was only letters, no phone calls, no emails, nothing. So I wrote him a letter every single day for 3 months. And then he got to
And you
come
took
back
up for- calligraphy, right?
Yes, yes.
So what? And you did drawings too, didn't you? And send those?
Right, both of us. So we're both
so
kind
cute.
Of artistic. And so, you know, he would, you know, draw little beautiful flourishes and roses on his letters, and mine would all be in calligraphy sealed with wax. They were pretty cute.
Oh,
so we
well.
Still have a big tub of all of our letters in our house on display, which is pretty fun. So then after boot camp, he was in D.C. for the next 8 months, and then it was in D.C. that we found out he was going to be shipping off to Okinawa Okinawa, Japan for 2 years.
Wow.
So that was kind of a hard pill to swallow. But then when he was home on leave between coming home from D.C. and shipping out, that when he proposed. So we went back to the ballroom where we met and dressed up. He was in one of his uniforms, and then he pulled me out. Like, cleared the stage, like, cleared the dance floor. He pulled me out.
He did?
Yes. So it was a full ballroom, but they cleared the stage, and we had a special dance, and then, you know, he took the mic and did his whole spiel. It was super romantic, and proposed, and all of my friends and family were there. He actually had my mom and dad and all of our parents hiding in the balcony, so they were there to see it. And
oh my goodness.
It was just such a special day. So and then he was off. So I was back here still in Seattle finishing up school, and had 2 years to plan our wedding, which was very good to have that to keep me busy while missing him.
Well, we're gonna actually get more into those questions after the break. Be sure to come back and join us. Lisa, we'll come back with you in just a few minutes.
Awesome. Sounds great.
All right. Thank you.
Play Radio, Tacoma's radio station. Play keeps you informed. 1180 AM.
Tacoma's radio station.
Attention business owners. Experience a new world of business with Barter. The Saturn Barter Company, located in Tacoma, is one of the most beneficial business decisions you can make. Using Saturn Barter, you are able to sell your products or services to other members of the exchange. You can then use that credit you've built up from your sales to purchase the products or services you or your company needs from other companies within Saturn Barter, all without the use of cash. Contact and join Saturn Barter Club today, 253-212-9930, or online at SaturnBarter.com.
This is Johnny the Gangster with Viva Productions, King of Entertainment, one-stop shop for all your entertainment needs. We have DJ service for weddings, corporate, and private events. Thrill your guests with Vegas Nights Casino Party, Blackjack, Craps, Roulette, Poker, and more. We also have event photography and limousine service. Call Viva Productions, 206-542-5733, or find us at viva-productions.com. A little less conversation, a little more action, you got it. Call Johnny the Gangster, I'll make you a deal you can't refuse.
Brides, do you want your big day to be stress-free, perfect, and stay within your budget? Well, Brides Club has all the inside information to make your dream a reality. Go to bridesclub.com, that's bride.com. See upcoming bridal shows and events, view wedding vendors and special offers. And don't miss The Spotlight, the premier online wedding magazine with valuable articles you can't afford to miss. Brides Club helps make your wedding stress-free and perfect. Go to bridesclub.com. Check out bridesclub.com. Life's a celebration. Grand Event Rentals makes your event their top priority. They are your full-service, special event, and party rental provider, supplying everything you need from start to finish. Their professional sales team and event staff work with you to create your dream event. With every event, Grand Event Rentals' customers' needs are the most important. Whether you're planning an intimate outdoor wedding or an elaborate black tie gala, the Grand Event Rentals specialists make great pride in providing our event planning experience to help create an unforgettable event. Please go and visit the Bellevue Showroom, Grand Event Rentals, or make a one-on-one appointment. Talk to them. They're trained, they're knowledgeable, they're event specialists, and they are going to take you through step-by-step everything that you need to make your day a success. Call Grand Event Rentals. Their number is 425-462-7368, or go to grandeventrentalswa.com.
Is your vehicle needing some attention? Take it over to Maddie's Tuning and Shoreline for fast, affordable car care. Trusted, professional, Maddie's services all makes and models and has been trusted in the Puget Sound for almost 60 years. Call Brian Maddie at 206-364-3347 or stop by his convenient location in Shoreline right on Aurora at 152nd. Maddie's Tuning. Call 206-364-3347. Trusted for almost 60 years to keep you safe and on the road.
Play Radio, Tacoma's radio station. Play keeps you informed. 1180 AM.
Tacoma's radio station.
Return to sender. Return to sender. I gave a letter
to the postman.
Welcome back. This is Viva Entertainment Talk Radio. We're here. I am Shell Culp with Essence of Events, filling in for Johnny while he's busy doing weddings and events today, actually. So I am here on air with Lisa. She's a former client of mine, a wonderful, wonderful gal. And we're talking about how we met at the Brides Club Wedding Expo and a little bit about her courtship. We were just discussing her wonderful fairy tale adventure. And we ended with your 2-year-long engagement.
Yeah.
So you were talking about, I was wondering, he got the whole, everybody off of the floor, right?
Yes, he cleared the whole floor. The DJ at the ballroom came on and said, you know, they were going to do, they called it a special homecoming dance or something, and had everyone clear. And so it was just us two, and it was one of, you know, our special songs that we loved. And so it was pretty special.
So what I'm sure everybody is wondering is, did he get down on his knee?
He did. Yes. After the dance, he, you know, professed his love and made it all very romantic, and then got down on one knee with the ring, and it was classic. Aww. It could not have been better.
Did you cry?
Oh, of course.
Aww, such a romantic story.
Yeah.
So then you were talking about how just a month after getting engaged, when that happened, you ended up going to the Brides Club Wedding Expos. What was the worst thing, or what did you have the hardest time with when you were planning your wedding?
Thankfully, I had a really great wedding planning experience because it was just a lot of fun for me and I had plenty of time. But I would definitely say by far the worst thing about planning the wedding was the guest list. Oh, that was nearly impossible. We knew we were going to have a big wedding, and it was big. You remember, it was like maybe 300 plus people.
Yeah.
But the guest list still has to stop somewhere.
Right.
And so doing my side of the family, you know, my side of the family is pretty large, lots of friends, but I knew everyone, and I knew like who needed to be there and kind of where that line stopped. But with his side, he's Filipino, and his Filipino family just goes on forever.
Yeah.
And he has just a really large family, and so it was so hard to try and figure out where that line stopped and who was important enough to make it and who wasn't. And, you know, it was, and he honestly didn't really know either.
Yeah.
So in retrospect, I think it would have been a lot easier for both of us had I enlisted maybe his sister or one of us, maybe his mom or someone else in his family to kind of say, okay, look, here's who needs to come. Because that was the tricky part, because it just kind of kept on going and going. I'm like, who are these random names who I've never
You're
heard
You're like,
of?
I haven't even met this person.
Right.
They're going to be at our wedding.
Exactly. So that was definitely tricky. And I think, because it was so big, it kind of made the line a little grayer. And, you know, you think, oh, big wedding, just invite everyone. Well, yes, but then still the line has to stop. So I feel like with small weddings, it's kind of easier to just be like, nope, like we're cutting it off here. But and maybe that's not the case, but it was tricky. And so I think with him being away and not able to just sit down and hash out that list, it was tricky.
Yeah. And you were involved in quite a few different hobbies and whatnot as well, right? So I'm sure you met people through that.
So there was a lot. There was a lot to do and a lot to figure out. So
I mentioned earlier in the show about recommending an ABC list. So like your immediate family and those who like must be there. You like couldn't live without them being there.
Right.
And then, you know, B being those who, you know, you're close friends with and family who maybe live out of state. And then, you know, your third list being acquaintances or people that maybe you work with at the office, you know, that you don't really spend a lot of time around. And then kind of just compiling that list and going off the A and B mostly until RSVPs start coming in. And then that's when you kind of start sending out, you know, the other ones. So did you have a strategy? Did you ever come up with anything?
I think from my side, I like I said, I knew who needed to be there and why and how and when. But, you know, it was...
You just didn't want to step on anyone's toes, you think?
Exactly.
New family. We don't want to be like, no. We don't want to say no.
Exactly. So we ended up kind of figuring out, you know, kind of who... Well, the kind of pockets of the family. Once you kind of group people, you know, it's like, well, if we invite this person, that means this group is coming, you know? So
yeah,
it kind of keeps everyone happy, but then we kind of cut it off at group lines.
Okay.
Where it's like, okay, maybe we don't invite, you know, this whole second cousin family, you know?
Yeah, so essentially that's very similar to the ABC method.
Yeah. That grouping people together definitely makes it easier, because then it kind of keeps you from getting hurt feelings, because, you know, once you group them together, you see that, well, if I only invite two people from this group, then all of these other people will probably feel really sad that they didn't get an invite. So it's like, if we're going to do this group at all, it's kind of all or nothing. So let's see if we have enough space for all of them, then great. If we don't have enough space for all of them, then maybe we do none of them.
Yeah.
So
yeah. Fair. Trying to be fair is not always easy,
right.
Is it?
Especially
yeah, with a wedding. And you have to stay within budget too. You know, some people don't even have a starting budget point, and you know that, you know, understandable, you know, if you're not really worried about it, it's not that big of a deal. But most people want to budget things in, because, you know, you're starting a new family and you don't want to go into debt walking into a marriage.
Absolutely.
And you know, you want to be able to go on a honeymoon and have that time together to spend together.
Absolutely.
Yeah. So what was the best thing that came out of your wedding planning?
The best thing about the wedding planning was definitely just the time and memories that I shared with my mom. We kind of did the whole thing together, and me and my mom are super close, and it was just a really, really sweet time. Wedding planning became our favorite hobby. Whenever we had free time to get together and do something wedding related, it was just so fun. And because we had a lot of time, and I'm an artist, so I was doing most of everything myself, the invitations, the flyer, you know, the handouts, the programs, the favors, the everything I did myself was kind of turned into a big art project for me, really.
Yeah, and I know when you guys, like I said earlier, when you guys came in to the show and we talked originally, you know, a lot of your questions had to do with, like, how involved are you? Are you okay with us taking care of these things? You know, we just need, you know, your help and your guidance on certain etiquette or ideas.
Absolutely.
Or finding, you know, vendor referrals that, you know, you can trust that we've worked with before. So, you know, I think that seemed really important to you guys to be able to have that time together.
Absolutely. Yeah. Ultimately, you know, when we were hiring a coordinator, we knew that it's like, we still kind of want to do it a lot ourselves and plan everything together. And because we had the time and it was so fun, but we also knew we needed someone to, okay, here's what we've done. Pass the torch, hand it over to you on the day to make sure everything gets executed the way we want, so that we can just sit back and enjoy our day, which is exactly what happened, which was just perfect.
Yeah. And then you mentioned that you did the invitations, and I know you did the centerpieces. You kind of already had those, like, pre-put together when we showed up.
Right. Yeah,
and we pretty much just had to, like, set them on the table, which I really appreciate.
Yeah, everything was
because, you know, we were setting up, it had to have been, I think, 40 tables. Wasn't it 40 tables?
I think it was 40.
Yeah. So, you know, having somebody who, you know, preps ahead of time, and you know, that was kind of a recommendation as well on my part, is, you know, it's always convenient to box everything up by table.
Right.
It makes the flow a lot easier on your setup team, for sure.
Yeah.
But tell me about the cake, and let everybody know, because this was a really brilliant idea that I actually had never seen before.
Okay, this is our little project. So, of course, I mean, our wedding was big and grand, and so I needed the big, giant, five-tier, glitz and glam wedding cake. You know, it just, I had to have it. But we had to stay in budget, and one of those cakes is probably, you know, a few grand. And so I was like, you know what? I've watched enough Cake Boss. I can figure something out. what I had seen on, you know, these cake shows is sometimes for the window displays, they would just do styrofoam covered in fondant, and they would still decorate it with icing and everything. But then it could just stay out there for a bit. And I was like, you know what? I could do that. So I bought huge, you know, big cylinder rounds of styrofoam.
Where did you get those from?
I found them online. You know, I was like, I need to make sure they're, you know, regular cake size, and that the tiers have the right, you know, spacing and proportions.
So did you cut them?
No, they came, well, we ended up cutting the bottom one.
Oh, okay.
So they came all in the right cylinder sizes. So the bottom one, here was our little trick, because we wanted this big thing, but we didn't necessarily want everyone to know that it was fake, right?
Yes.
And we still wanted to cut into it. So from the bottom tier, we cut out a wedge of the styrofoam and covered the whole thing and bonded it and decorated it. And then, you know, right before the wedding, we put in just a wedge of real cake into that little wedge and covered the seam with like a bow so that you really could not even tell. And so on the day, the whole cake was styrofoam except for that little wedge, and we knew exactly where to cut in. So we were able to cut our cake and have our little time, and then they wheeled that cake away and then wheeled out sheet cake from the back, and no one ever knew.
Yeah, brilliant, brilliant idea. Like I said, I had never seen that before, and I thought it was just such a good idea. You know, I mean, awesome. If for that many people, like you said, to have a grand cake would be so expensive.
It would be so expensive. So I did that whole thing myself. I got pretty handy with fondant and royal icing and hand decorated it and, you know, draped all the little pearls, and like it was kind of made it easy that it wasn't going to be eaten, so I could actually be like, oh, I can just drape real strings of pearls around here because no one's going to eat it. It'll look great. So I decorated that whole big thing myself. That was kind of my pride and joy.
And how did you guys end up cutting your cake? What did you use?
We used his sword.
Yeah.
So that was a really fun, special moment. So he unsheathed that, and it was pretty cool. And so we got to cut the cake with his sword, which was pretty fun.
That's awesome. Yeah. So for our listeners, if you want to see a picture of them actually cutting that cake that she was talking about, you can go to Essence of Events Facebook page. That's www.facebook.com/EssenceOfEvents, and you will see a picture of that on there. It's pretty elaborate and pretty incredible. And then, yeah, what a cute little picture of them too. It's adorable.
Oh, yeah.
Well, Lisa, we're going to go to break, but I'd love to bring you back if you don't mind. Trong is still kind of caught up with photographing the Mariners. So if you don't mind staying on, we'd love to have you back. So we'll be back in just a little bit after the break.
Awesome. I'll hang around.
He put it in his sack. Bright and early next morning, he brought my letter back. She wrote upon it, return to sender. Address unknown. No such number.
Play Radio, Tacoma's radio station. Play keeps you informed. 1180 AM.
Tacoma's radio station.
Attention business owners. Experience a new world of business with Barter. The Saturn Barter Company, located in Tacoma, is one of the most beneficial business decisions you can make. Using Saturn Barter, you are able to sell your products or services to other members of the exchange. You can then use that credit you've built up from your sales to purchase the products or services you or your company needs from other companies within Saturn Barter, all without the use of cash. Contact and join Saturn Barter Club today, 253-212-9930, or online at SaturnBarter.com.
This is Johnny the Gangster with Viva Productions, King of Entertainment, one-stop shop for all your entertainment needs. We have DJ service for weddings, corporate, and private events. Thrill your guests with Vegas Nights Casino Party, Blackjack, Craps, Roulette, Poker, and more. We also have event photography and limousine service. Call Viva Productions, 206-542-5733, or find us at Viva-Productions.com. A little less conversation, a little more action, you got it. Call Johnny the Gangster, I'll make you a deal you can't refuse.
Brides, do you want your big day to be stress-free, perfect, and stay within your budget? Well, Brides Club has all the inside information to make your dream a reality. Go to BridesClub.com, that's BridesClub.com. See upcoming bridal shows and events, view wedding vendors and special offers. And don't miss The Spotlight, the premier online wedding magazine with valuable articles you can't afford to miss. Brides Club helps make your wedding stress-free and perfect. Go to BridesClub.com. Check out BridesClub.com.
Life's a celebration. Grand Event Rentals makes your event their top priority. They are your full-service, special event, and party rental provider, supplying everything you need from start to finish. Their professional sales team and event staff work with you to create your dream event. With every event, Grand Event Rentals customers' needs are the most important. Whether you're planning an intimate outdoor wedding or an elaborate black tie gala, the Grand Event Rentals specialists make great pride in providing our event planning experience to help create an unforgettable event. Please go and visit the Bellevue Showroom, Grand Event Rentals, or make a one-on-one appointment. Talk to them. They're trained, they're knowledgeable, they're event specialists, and they are going to take you through step-by-step everything that you need to make your day a success. Call Grand Event Rentals. Their number is 425-462-7368, or go to grandeventrentalswa.com.
Is your vehicle needing some attention? Take it over to Maddie's Tuning and Shoreline for fast, affordable car care. Trusted, professional, Maddie's services all makes and models and has been trusted in the Puget Sound for almost 60 years. Call Brian Maddie at 206-364-3347 or stop by his convenient location in Shoreline right on Aurora at 152nd. Maddie's Tuning. Call 206-364-3347. Trusted for almost 60 years to keep you safe and on the road.
Making a difference 1 hour at a time. KLAY 1180 AM, your conversation station for Pierce County, South King County, Tacoma, Federal Way, and Olympia. KLAY now joins our regular programming in progress.
Joining us, this is Shel Culp with Viva Entertainment Talk Radio. I'm filling in for Johnny with Viva Productions. You can find Johnny at www.viva-productions.com. And again, I'm Shel Culp with Essence of Events. And here on the show, we've been going over money-saving tips earlier in the show. And then we've actually been interviewing Lisa, which is a former client that we had in Bride, getting her point of view and hearing about her fairy tale wedding and money saving tips, which I really appreciate for all of those listeners out there who want to save really on any event. We were just discussing how the wedding was going and about your grand cake and cutting it with a sword and
yes.
So what I'd really like to know, and for our listeners to know, I'm sure they want to know what your favorite moments were at your wedding.
Favorite moments. I do have a few. The first favorite moment, of course, is when those church doors opened and I saw my lovely groom staring back at me. We had waited. We didn't do a first look. So this was the first time, you know, first time he laid eyes on me as a bride. And there was just so many emotions. And to see that church full of my closest friends and family, to see them all rise, and just, I just felt like a princess. It was just magical. The music was perfect, and just to see the emotions on his face, because he did get pretty emotional, which then of course I was also, we were just all crying.
Yeah, I think everybody in the audience was, including us. We were peering over from up above from the little balcony watching. I think there wasn't a dry eye.
Yeah, I don't think so. We had specifically put little handkerchiefs in all the ceremony programs because we knew it'd be a pretty emotional day. So it was just walking down that aisle is something I had just dreamt of for so long, and it was just everything and more than I could have dreamed of. And just seeing him, just the way he was looking at me, it just made everything just perfect. And so that was just so, so special. Just couldn't have been better. And then I also, another one of my favorite moments was our first dance, which was a waltz. It was a grand waltz. It's actually a song that my husband Nathaniel had written me on piano, so it was a recording of him playing piano. So it was a very special song for the two of us, and so we danced and waltzed to that song, and it was again one of just those perfect moments that I had dreamt of for so long. That was just surreal, just to be in that ballroom with everyone there, everyone we know and love, watching us, and just to be floating across that dance floor in my big dress and my tiara, and it just was pretty perfect.
Yeah, oh my goodness, it was like a fairy tale for sure. I mean, you guys literally were just like floating around the floor. I think the only thing that maybe would have made it a little bit better is if you guys had like the little fog machine.
Right. Yes,
it would look like you guys were just like floating on clouds, because you were just so graceful, and the way you've always carried yourself, you know, I've always found to be so graceful too. And so, you know, seeing you two together, you know, in his uniform and you in your beautiful princess gown. Had you dreamt about this day since you were a little girl?
Oh, absolutely. I have always been like, the wedding has always been my life. Like, I've always dreamt about it. when can I get married? When will I meet the man I'm going to marry? And I've just dreamt about my whole life. I've always been, you know, just the whole thing. I knew I wanted it to be grand and, you know, the biggest dress I could find, and I just needed that princess day. So I definitely dreamt about that day for just my whole life, and now it's so fun. Whenever it comes up, me and my mom just think, how did we have the best wedding day ever? Like, it was just everything and more than we could have dreamed of. And my mom always tells me, you know, just the time that we got to spend together. But for her as a mom to see me get the wedding of my dreams was just so special for her as well. So it was really something else.
That's so funny, because I was just going to ask you if you got your wedding of your dreams.
I did. Perfect. And even more. It's like it was even better than I could have ever dreamed. It was just a really perfect day. Somehow everything just worked out, and especially with so many people, so many big things. You know, obviously I had these big dreams, and you know, was very specific about a lot of things. So for it to go that well was just outstanding. So probably had a lot to do with good hiring great people like you to make sure it all went smoothly. Oh. And if anything didn't go right, then maybe I just didn't. Yeah. Really felt like a perfect day. And just looking back on it, I really wouldn't have changed, you know, fairly a thing. So it was just great.
Yeah, I think, you know, that's a lot of why I went into this industry, you know, being raised around it and seeing the joy that it brings people, you know, the happiness, and they're well-dressed and their smiles on their faces. And, you know, to be a part of that and a part of someone's life, even if it's for a brief period of time, you know, there's really no better feeling. You know, it's one of the pleasures, you know, and enjoyments that I get out of my job. And, you know, I've had this company for 16 years now, and, you know, was raised around it. My parents used to hold weddings out of our house. And so, you know, I was little, 7 years old, you know, tying up little favors for couples. And so to see a fairy tale story like this, you know, really kind of reinvigorates us as vendors. You know, when we see couples, you know, that are getting married, you know, and enjoying the process and are working together. And I think in general, it just inspires everybody around you when you have that kind of energy. Mm-hmm. So, you know, it wasn't just a wonderful day for you. You know, it was wonderful for me as well. Oh, and, good. You know, I really appreciate that we were able to be a part of that too. Is there anything that you would have changed at all?
The only thing I would have changed, and I think this probably goes to show about how great of a day it was, that literally the only thing I would have changed is remembering to grab the mic and thank my guests, because there were so many of them that I just feel like I was never really able to share my deep gratitude for them being there and sharing that day with us, because I wasn't able to, you know, talk with or even see a lot of the people who were there. We were just so caught up in just all of enjoying the enjoyment of it all. But if I could have just grabbed that mic after the toast and just really took a second to thank all my guests, I think that would have just been really good. If I thought about it beforehand and put it on the schedule, I know what would have happened. But it was one of those things like, you know what, I should have done that. I should have taken the time. So that would have been the only thing that I really would have changed, because everything else was just exactly how I had envisioned it and better. So that would have been the only thing I would have hoped to be able to squeeze in there, to just be able to take a second, say, I know I won't be able to see all of you and hug all of you and thank all of you, but just to make sure everyone knew how grateful I was. Because, it wouldn't have been for all of them there that it was just such a perfect day, you know.
So let's go back to those toasts. You know, a lot of people... You probably know where this is going. A lot of people only usually think about having their dad speak or their maid of honor and best man. Right. And so, you know, it's not very common to have, you know, at the end, a couple say, you know, a little appreciation. But, you know, you have the opportunity now. Grab that microphone. What would you say? What would you say to them if they were you're right back there? What would you say to them if you could?
Right back there, and just looking out at all my wedding guests, I would just tell them, thank you all for being here. I know so many of them came from afar and flew and just took time out of their life to share that day with us. So just to say thank you, and we cherish all of you. You are a part of our story. You're here because we love you and you're a part of our lives, and we hope that you continue to be a part of our lives through our marriage and to see us through all the times ahead of us, and just to make sure they know. I know I won't be able to see you all and shake your hand and hug you all in person. There's so many of you here, but each one of you being here means so much to me.
Well, we got that on recording, so you'll be able to share it with them. So I'm all about no regrets.
Yeah, perfect. Well, that will be.
Things come back around for a reason, for sure. And, you know, I really appreciate you sharing that with us and for everybody. If you could give, if you could give brides any advice, what kind of advice would you give them?
I would say, one, enjoy the process. I know probably everyone says this, but, and I know some people enjoy wedding planning a lot more.
Thank you, Lisa, for being on our show. We're actually ending the show. Okay. I mean, it was wonderful to have you on. Yeah. Thank you, listeners. I'm Shell with Essence of Events. This has been Viva Entertainment Talk Radio. Join us next week at noon.
Thank you.